Grab yourself a pen, grab some paper. It is time to play Family Fortunes / Family Feuds. If you've never seen either of the TV shows, they are very similar. Basically, a producer will go out into the public and ask random questions to 100 people. These questions can be anything from name an essential item you buy at the supermarket, or name a film that's always on Christmas Day. And then people have got to try and come up with the top answers. And that is my challenge to you. I'm going to play some actual clips from the TV shows, and you've got to come up with the top 5 answers. Okay, you'll get a point for the top 5th, 4th or 3rd answer. You will get 2 points if you can get the 2nd most popular answer. And because I'm feeling generous, 3 points for getting that top answer. So you're going to see actual clips from the shows, and you've then got to write down what you think are going to be the top 5 answers. It's as simple as that. Are you ready? Let's do this.
We surveyed 100 people. We asked them, can you name something that you would hate to see when you return to your parked car?
Cassie.
A parking ticket.
Parking tickets. Can't stand parking tickets. All right, let's have a look. Our survey says... top answer, of course. No then.
Flat tyre.
Oh, good answer. I like that. Flat tyre. Puncture. Let's have a look. Our survey says... yes.
Not being there.
An empty space.
Damaged, like a key or...
Oh, let's have a look. Someone scratched it, keyed it, damaged. Our survey says... yes!
I'm going to go with a clamped.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. Clamped. Good answer, Matt. Let's have a look. Our survey says...
yeah.
Yes, well done. Let's have a look. The 6th most popular answer was...
oh!
Bed paralysis!
Folks, here we go. Point values of double. We've got the top 5 answers on the board. Fill in the blank. The 3 what?
Stooges.
The 3 Stooges.
The Musketeers.
3 Musketeers.
Amigos.
The 3 Amigos. James, fill in the blank. The three what?
Blind mice.
Three blind mice, yeah. Hey, Mike, fill in the blank. The three what?
The three little pigs.
Yeah.
The three little pigs. Number four.
We surveyed 100 people. We're looking for the top six answers. Name something that people do for luck. Very quick, Joe.
For luck, they carry a rabbit's foot.
A rabbit's foot?
A rabbit's foot.
A rabbit's foot.
Right, look. Up there for thinking, down there for dancing.
It's the youth of today, Paul. He's rude. He is rude.
He's very, very rude.
He is. You're saying a lucky rabbit's foot?
Rabbit's foot.
Our survey says... it's there. Carry a charm. It's not the most popular answer, Joe, which means, Paul, you get the chance to give me an answer. If you can find the top answer, you are in control of the board.
Right, then. They don't walk under a ladder.
Don't walk under a ladder.
Sir, good answer.
Paul Daniels is saying you don't walk under a ladder. Our survey says...
take your knickers off.
Attracted you to the lovely Debbie McGee. Take your knickers off, Paul. You can have one of them or one of your own. What are you going to go for?
Well, you can throw salt over your thing. I think touch wood.
Yeah? Touch wood for the board to steal the points from the Swash family, who are still conferring. I don't think they understand the rules, but never mind. You're saying touch wood. Our survey says... yes! Well done, the Daniels family. Let's find out what those missing answers were. The sixth most popular answer was... wear lucky pants.
See, you took them off.
Yeah. All right. The fifth most popular answer was... wish or pray. The fourth most popular answer was... salt over your shoulder. You said that, Paul.
I had that one.
You said that. And finally, let's take a look at what the top answer was. Cross fingers. Said that as well.
Well done.
Hey, fellas, here we go. Top five answers on the board. Name an occupation in which you meet a lot of drunk people. Thank you. Aaron.
Bartender.
Bartender.
Yeah. Yeah. We're gonna play.
They're gonna play. Hey, Megan, name an occupation where you meet a lot of drunk people.
A waiter or waitress?
Waiter, yeah. Waitress. Woo. Hey, Corey, tell me an occupation where you meet a lot of drunk people.
Police officer.
Yep, oh, police yeah. officer. Scott, tell me an occupation where you meet a lot of drunk people.
How about working at a homeless shelter?
Homeless shelter. Leah, name an occupation which you meet a lot of drunk people.
I'm gonna say a hospital. Maybe they're coming in, they've yeah. messed themselves
a
up.
A hospital. All right, Aaron, it's always tough when it gets back to who started. You gotta be careful. You got two strikes. Hodge's family can steal.
I'm gonna say a bouncer.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. A bouncer. Yeah. Megan, one answer left. If it's there, you clear the board. Name an occupation in which you meet a lot of drunk people.
A vendor at a sporting event.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. That's it. That's it.
A vendor at a sporting event. Oh. Number five. Two good families.
We surveyed 100 people looking for the top five answers. Name something people put in their mouths every day. Vicky.
Toothbrush.
A toothbrush. Well done. Sensible answer. You're saying a toothbrush. Our survey says. Yes, well done. It's only the second most popular answer, though. Steve, if you can get that top answer, you take control of the board, and hopefully we'll get some points on the board. What do you think?
Food.
Food. You're saying food. Our survey says. Yeah! Your final pass.
Water.
Our survey says. It's not there, Susie. Unlucky. Richard, what do you think?
A fork.
You're saying fork? Our survey says... yes!
Toothpaste.
Let's have a look. So we're saying toothpaste. Our survey says... it's not there. Unlucky. Get ready, Jones family. You might be over there. You might get a chance to steal. Paul, what do you think?
I would say drink.
You're saying drink. Our survey says... it's not there. Unlucky. Right, let's take a look at those two remaining answers. The fifth most popular answer was... false teeth! Of course, of course. And the fourth most popular was... a foot!
Oh, I said that.
Top six answers on the board. Name something a person might ask you to hold. Thank you. Will?
Money.
Money.
Their hand.
Their hand. They're going to play. All right, Nick, let's go. Name something a person might ask you to hold.
Someone might ask you to hold a piece of clothing, jacket.
Hold a piece of clothing. Hey, Carrie, name something a person might ask you to hold.
I often ask Nick to hold my purse.
Ask him to hold your purse. Mickey, name something a person might ask you to hold.
They might ask you to hold their baby.
Hold the baby. Hey, John, name something a person might ask you to hold.
Their confidence. A secret.
Their confidence. Anna, you got to be careful now. We got two strikes. Osby family can steal.
Hold them up. Like they're falling, hold them up.
Hold them up. All right, Osby family, here's your chance, Larissa. Name something a person might ask you to hold.
Hold their spot in line.
Hold their spot in line. Number six. Driving out of here in a brand new